Jay Shrek, you are not going to believe where we're at today. We've taken on a challenge today that we're going to do a trip that most people seem to do in about 3 days. And we're going to do it in 1 day. So we're going to go from Phoenix to Yuma. That don't sound like a lot though, does it? But I'll tell you what, we're going to take El Camino Del Diablo, the road of the devil. And we're going to run this 100 miles this morning, well, throughout the day. And we're going to do it in a day. So we got up at 4, we left at 5. And so right now what John's doing is he is airing down. And we're getting ready to have an adventure. Now we're going to be on this road for a couple days, but today what our goal is to be able to get in and out and run this in a day and still see a lot of stuff. And then we're going to come back down and hike it. I think I'm even going to take a motorcycle ride on it. And we're even talking about challenging ourselves to hike this. And I can't wait. I'm excited. This is going to be a great trip. Unreal. The road of the devil. So we're starting off in Ajo, Arizona, and then we're going to end up in Yuma. And we're here right here, right before golden hour. So it's still, the light's coming, but it's not quite there yet. But I am so pumped up today. I've been wanting to do this. The road of the devil, the deadliest road in the U.S. history before 1900. How incredible is that? And we're going to take that. We're going to take you along today as we air down the FJ, and we're going to have an adventure. Aren't we, John? We're airing down.
No, I am.
I'm holding your nuts?
Yeah, go to work.
Yes.
That's right.
Okay. He says he's a morning guy, but he's a little cranky this morning. You know, it's not bad. It's pretty barely. Ooh, I dropped it. I don't want to do that.
So what do we have here on the right? I don't know yet.
We have a big pile of rocks.
Pile of rocks.
So I'm real curious to see what kind of speed that we can travel safely now that we're aired down. The first like hour, 2 hours, I watched the guy do this whole deal yesterday. He took 3 days, but I watched all of it. I watched him go down this road in 5 times the speed he was really going. And this video was still an hour and 30 minutes.
Yeah.
So that would put it at 5.5, 6, 6.5 hours is what I'm guesstimating.
Well, it's 130 miles, but it's 100 to where we head up to Welton. If you go the Welton way, which we're going to do, depending on what we have for time. But even if we had extra time, it's not going to be enough time to climb that mountain.
So there's a bunch of people already here.
Yeah, already, huh?
Let me know. I'm just going to give a little shot out the back. Get that dust as we're blowing through here.
Enter the
organ. Now we stopped in the chola fields, and you know, it's so beautiful out here. You forget that this was one of the most deadliest roads ever. Now we're coming up on Bates Well, and all of a sudden, man, look how healthy these plants are. And you can definitely tell that they definitely got water in this area, which would probably be the reason why there's Bates Well, but this is really a healthy desert. I mean, this place is absolutely just beautiful. You know, you don't see pristine desert like this. And you know, the Spaniards, now the ancients been traveling this road for thousands of years. So For thousands of years, they rode this trail to San Diego, up coming up from Rocky Point and Mexico City. Now, in 1540, the Spaniards came through here. And you know, one thing that people don't realize is that the conquistadors, they were probably some of the baddest hombres that you're going to come across. They were bad. They were badasses. They were the Navy SEALs plus. Now, they came from a place in Spain where they had trained, where it was extremely hot, just like this. So they were used to this kind of conditions. And it's just amazing that, you know, they say over 2,000 people, there's a hell of a lot more than that died on this road. And that's what the kind of the hard part is when you look at it and you see all this green beauty, but you realize in reality, I mean, this was the deadliest road in the United States. More people lost their life on this road than anywhere. And you kind of don't grasp that because it doesn't appear to be that way. But deep down, you know that this place was just devastating.
What do we do, park and get out?
Yeah, we can do whatever we want. Ain't nobody here. This is an old ranch.
Yeah. Jeff's going to make it work.
Yeah. Well, one of the first stops we're making is Bates Well, because I've seen this in every video. And this was a working cattle ranch. And it's really cool that it's still available. And you're out here in the middle of nowhere. And how awesome is this? This is really a cool place. And we're going to take a look inside. So what it says is, the ranching years for 4 decades. Henry Gray was the last private owner of Bates Well and the last of the ranches in the monument. Usually a ranch is prohibited. The Gray family ranched throughout the monument area for 17 years before Oregon Pipe Cactus National Monument was established in 37. They were allowed to continue partly because this country was their home and ranching their livelihood, even though the ranching operations conflicted with policies. Died in 1976. Man, look at this. Let's just come in here and take a look. See what this is. This is so awesome. This is still here. Isn't this cool? Look at this. How awesome is this? That this is still here. And you can put your hands on the walls and look in here. You know, this is where they lived out his life. How amazing is this, that this place is still here? How awesome is this? Wow, I mean, this is intriguing. This is really a neat place that it's still here. The old table, closet. Wow. How cool is this? Wow, this is really neat.
That is anybody was, home?
No one's home. Everyone's gone.
Yeah, like the director.
Now we're gonna go on down the path here, and go to the back building, and take a look around. You know, one of the things I didn't figure. So when you figure out all this stuff, one thing I didn't figure was how beautiful it is out here. This is one of the most beautiful, pristine deserts that I have seen. Let's take a look at this building here and see what's here. Oh, this is an old tank. Some of the ranching operations, you know, water was critical for cattle and any other wildlife. So let's take a look down here and walk down here and see what's down here. I'll tell you what, I have not seen desert this beautiful in a long, long time. So if you get a chance to take a walk down here, maybe a ride would be a better way to put that. You can see a bunch of tracks here, and they're actually animal tracks. Not, there's a few human, but most of these are animal. So I'll be real curious to find out what's down here. How beautiful is this area? tell you, this is really, I've been wanting to do this for a long time, but because of the history of this and the Spaniards and the 49ers and the different groups and the ancients and the later Indian tribes that that raised havoc down here. So it's really pretty cool. Seen some deer tracks. I'm sure there's all kinds of different deer down here. And look through here. Look at these old buildings down here. You know, we're going right down the same trails that the ranchers, you know, use forever. And this is just a really cool, cool place. Look at this old shack right here. Whatever signs were there are gone. It's like where they're at, they're tacked. Right here. You know, these old buildings lasted a hell of a long time. It's really pretty incredible. Let's take a look at this one here. This is really a beautiful place. I'm just, let's see if we can't get this off. Oh, there we go. Ooh, oh, there's the kangaroo rats or the pack rats right there. They're living in here. Really nice place though. Had a heater right there. Potbelly stove would sit right there. Wow, how cool is that? And you know, on this stuff, make sure you lock it back up. And then let's take a look at the lifeblood of this place. Because this was it, right here. Here was the water. And then there's corrals here, there's the chutes. I love these old fences right here. I love these old fences where they used to rack them like that. You see, you saw that down by Picacho Mountains, the same type of fencing. And it's been around. Those are old, old, old fences. Look, here's another building right here. Still standing. Let's see what's in this one. Had a nice sign at one time. Wish I knew what it said. I'm gonna make sure we don't fall through. Somebody's rebuilt it, kept it in, which is nice. Somebody's definitely tried to make sure the structure didn't fall, which was pretty cool. You know, that's neat. I love preservation, especially in an area where. Get over here. What's over here? Wow, this is a neat place. Look how green this is. This is just beautiful. I'll tell you what, if that isn't an old, I've got to get a good picture of this down here. Tell you what, I'm impressed with this. You know, we've got that same windmill at the ranch. It's amazing how at Chicago, Illinois, all those basically came out of Chicago, Illinois. Isn't that incredible? Look at this old water tank. This is just beautiful. It's a nice water trough right there. So there's the... How cool is that? How neat is this? I love these old tanks. You know, most of the ones you see are like recreations, you know? And here we are, we're seeing the real deal. How cool is this? This is neat. This is neat. Wow. Man. Look down in here. Is anything in there? Let's lock that down, which is good. Nothing wrong with that. Look at this place. I tell you what, this is just a fabulous trip. Let's take just a little look down here just to see. Here's a little. Just take a look through here and see if there's anything down here. How cool is this? I tell you what, man, we picked a hell of a trip. This is the cool place. Look at that right through there. Let's get that shot right coming through there. Oh man, I tell you what, I'm pumped up because I tell you, this is beautiful. This is beautiful. How cool is this? Bates Well. Man, you talk about peace and quiet. He definitely had peace and quiet. Another windmill over there. These flowers are getting ready to bloom. They're not out just yet, but boy, it's close. They're getting there. Well, the first big stop we've taken, we took a couple of little stops for some cactus and some of that, but I'm telling you, look at this beauty. Those cactus are so pristine. Look how healthy that dude is. You really do see what man-made damage. You don't see these, you don't see all the damage to these you see elsewhere near the city. But I tell you, that's a pretty cool deal. Wow. Man, I'm excited. I don't know about you guys, but I'm telling you what, this was a hell of a cool stop. So now it's about, how we journey on. See what else this journey is going to have in store for us today, because I'm telling you, so far this is beautiful, absolutely beautiful. You know, he lived his life out. He did his work and lived his life out right there. I saw one over there on the other side too that was kind of out by it on its lonesome. Look how flat this is out here. Ain't nothing out here.
We gotta go straight southwest for your Tinajas Altas adventure. Road to the left. Road to the left. Goes to Pozo Nuevo, Quito, Baquito, and Lukeville.
Quito, Baquito? Yeah, Quito, Baquito is way down by the border.
If you have your eyes sharp, you might see Sonoran pronghorn in this area.
I'm sharp. I'm looking sharp.
Oh, I want to take a picture of that.
Take some pictures.
You're not getting out, Marie.
You said she had to stay in here.
She gave me hell. You have to let her out.
Okay, I was just following instructions. Yeah, you do. You have to. Cabeza Prieta. Okay, so we're leaving the organ pipe, and then there's the facility where the border patrol are at, Now, one thing about this area, there's been over 500 deaths of people coming through here that didn't make it. So, you know, that's kind of what you get here. You know, you look at the beauty of this place, but you realize when it gets hot that it changes. It changes. It becomes pretty evil. You know, on this beautiful day like today, it's really awesome. But you know what? When the heat comes, I'm telling you what, man, this place becomes deadly. You know, and that many immigrants coming through here that's died it just shows you the amount of deaths through here because of the extreme heat. So now we're getting into the wildlife refuge right here. Now we did some work up here when we did some petroglyphs on this other side that would be north of here. That would still be in the Cabeza Prieta. So here's where we're at. Right here. You know, just a fascinating place. If you sign in here, okay, we're gonna sign in here. Well, we're gonna try to sign in here, but there's no sign in, so we're not gonna sign in here. So now normally you would sign in here, right here, and then you'd put it here, but they don't have any place to sign in. So I guess we're not going to sign in, even though we do have passes. So, yeah. Kind of sad they're not too prepared out here, but I guess that's the way it is. Please register, if we could register. And then you can see here, nobody's touched that for a while. So that's kind of interesting. So I guess we're not going to sign in. So we'll go off on the road. Well, you know, that's just the way it is. So, you know, I'm really surprised, though. I'm really surprised that there's nobody, there's nothing to be able to sign in on. But it is what it is. What's that? What's that? Probably what's that? Water. What's that right there? What's that right there? What is that? How the hell did, look how big he is. Holy shit.
Wow,
he is huge as I am.
Monster. Look at John. Let me see. I gotta see with the binoculars.
Man, it's bad when I'm the guy to spot.
Oh, this is gorgeous.
Oh, he looked good. You can see the wetness still in the road.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not wet. It's not, but you know, you can see where it was wet, definitely. So as we look around here, we're in a specific area they call Chinaman Flats. And what the hell was that about? Well, there's two stories to Chinaman Flats. So let's look around real quick. And this is definitely a flat area right here. Look how beautiful this is. Wow, this is incredible. So, Chinaman Flats. It's thought that Chinese immigrants came here to farm. But another story is that they were brought across the border and murdered on this very ground. I'd like to hope that the first story was the story. But either way, I don't see any remnants. But look at this. Look how flat this is. This is just beautiful. Just incredible. I mean, I'm awe-inspired by this. The landscape, if you want to see pristine desert, you're not going to find any better desert than we've seen all the way from Ajo. I mean, the place is just beautiful. It's just beautiful. That was it.
I think that was it.
That's okay. I can shoot it anywhere, you know.
Okay.
You want to get out here?
Yeah. You know, there was a tragedy that happened in May of 2001, and it happened on this peak over here and then on to the other side. What happened was 14 immigrants were coming across the border in this very location, and the smugglers left them, and they become disoriented and died out here just north of this mound over here, which is pretty incredible because, you know, it doesn't look, you know, you're out here on this day to day and it's so peaceful and it's so beautiful. But when you get out here and you don't know what you're doing, it can be deadly. And that happened in May of 2001. So the amount of deaths that happened across this border through here, I mean, is really, I mean, it's so sad, you know, that so many people, you know, just trying to get across, you know, die out here because of how deadly this is. So when we talk about the 2,000 deaths that were out here, we don't realize that, you know, that's not even close. There's been thousands more deaths out here since the days before 1870, because in 1870, they actually put the train in and this kind of shut this trail, this highway of the devil down. So then people took the train. So basically technology saved a bunch of people's lives out here. But it's so tragic that that people are coming across here and dying out here in this desert, and it's so beautiful, but it's that's a tragedy. It's so weird because it's so nice out here, but you don't really see the other side of it, which is that, man, people come out here and they try to get across the border and they die. And they die a lot. It's not some rare occasion. And this is just a small section of the whole area from California to Texas. And we're just in a little small panel of that. And you can imagine how many people lose their lives coming across here. But, you know, it is what it is. We just went by the Papago campgrounds. And now where we're at right now is Papago Well, Tule Well. So the Tule Well is 32 miles this way. There is a flag right there showing that there's water here. And then there is the...